want to see if we could talk to you about your DUI last night.
Silence tonight from a central Minnesota mayor arrested for drinking and driving and causing a crash. But it turns out he never even went to jail. State Patrol officers took Brad Gunderson home after police say that he caused a crash not far from his home. Gunderson is in his first term as mayor of Sauk Rapids, just outside St. Cloud. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Todd Wilson went there today to investigate the allegations.
That's interesting.
Eric Anderson just found out his mayor, the mayor of Sauk Rapids, was arrested for a DWI right outside Anderson's front door Sunday afternoon.
I would hope he'd resign or do the appropriate thing.
Here's the damage from the crash. Two green trash cans were destroyed, plus this fluorescent yellow crosswalk sign at the intersection of Summit Avenue North and 9th Avenue. I went to Mayor Bradley Gunderson's house to speak with him.
Hello, Mayor Gunderson.
Yes.
Todd Wilson, Channel 5. Want to see if we could talk to you about your DUI last night.
The next step was to call City Hall, and I was able to get a hold of Councilman Paul Weber. I talked to him by phone, and he told me he was aware of the situation with the mayor, but he referred me to the police chief. Weber didn't want to talk about the arrest any further than that. We then found Councilman Nick Sauer at his house, but Sauer didn't want to speak either.
You guys are public officials. You guys are voted in. You're not going to speak to the people?
No, sir.
Late this evening, Police Chief Perry Bice sent out a release confirming the arrest. It says his department investigated a one-car property damage accident. During their investigation, Mayor Gunderson was arrested for driving while intoxicated. Gunderson provided a urine sample to State Patrol, and they eventually dropped him off at his home. So far, no charges have been filed. Well, he did not go to jail. He was dropped off at his home. That's right. The next thing, though, is the urine sample. It will be tested by the state. If Gunderson was drunk, he could face charges.
You've also been looking into his past, and this isn't the only offense.
No, this is not the only offense. In fact, he was convicted of DWI in 85 in Anoka, and then in 91 in Stearns County. So this is not his first go around.
We'll see where it goes from here. Todd, thanks.
No
Bill?